Ethan is getting his mother-in-law and bringing her to the back of the sanctuary for the procession. She just gave me strict instructions. She said, you know me, I got the gift of gab. But I don't want to talk in front of people. Yeah, right. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to be able to take a few moments of this time to have something very, very sacred and recognize something very, very holy. I was being a little bit silly before the service, and Ned and I have a relationship that is both social and spiritual, and sometimes I'm known as the playful pastor, and I've been known to have fun at parties. I've seen that Ned has been known to have fun at parties, and we're going to have a lot of fun. Y'all are already been chitting and chatting, and I couldn't help but come and try to find out what some of these wonderful relationships are. You are all here just to honor a couple that you love who've been married for 50 years. And that really is a landmark. That is something significant. And so I covenanted with Darren and April and Ned and Leann that I would do my best to allow them just to enjoy this day and enjoy your friendship and fellowship. That's what they really want to do. But we would be amiss if we didn't recognize a very, very, very holy thing that we're having the privilege to witness. A man and a woman united together in holy matrimony for 50 years. What God has joined together, amen? Let's have a word of prayer. Lord Jesus, we thank you so much for this holy day as we recognize and we see evidence of the special gift that you've given to Ned and Leann, 50 years of marital unity, and the gift you've given to the body of Christ, a visual of what the relationship that you want us to have with you is. Today, Lord, be glorified. In Jesus' name I pray. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Amen. I'm going to ask if... Children, would you bring your parents to the front? Ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand? Friends and family, we're gathered today in celebration of God's manifest love. Ned and Leann Smith, we rejoice to celebrate with you the renewal of your marriage covenant on this, your 50th wedding anniversary. And we celebrate the delight that you have found in each other. And we thank you for being a sign of God's love among us. And already you're crying. That's why I brought these chairs, to give you a crutch. So would you just help your mom and dad to those chairs right there and let them just get very comfortable.
Who stands to attest to the holy union of this man and this woman for 50 years?
Well, I would like to say that this man married me and my wife almost 25 years ago. And part of our wedding, there was a phrase in it that said, a strand, a cord of three strands is not easily broken. Yeah. It meant that my wife and I, as long as we kept Jesus in the center of our marriage, it would be strong. 50 years ago, I happen to know that this couple wasn't saved yet. They didn't have Jesus in the center of their home when they first started. But praise the Lord, they found him before I was even born.
Hallelujah.
So I ask you today, going forward, will you keep Jesus in the center of your home and have a strand, a cord of three strands? And I give you my permission to marry my mother.
there, no matter what. I can depend on them night or day. I can call them at 3 o'clock in the morning, and they are there. And I know that I can always depend on them. And it's not just me calling my mom. It's me calling both of them. And as a couple together, they are so, they're always just so right there and right on and can always know exactly what I need to hear, even if I don't want to hear it. So I'm just saying, I hope it's another 50 years.
The way it is the way that it is.